Welcome to Prophetic Ministry at Unity with Heaven. At Unity with Heaven, for the last 3 years, we've been ministering prophetically to people on Mondays and Fridays. And when we prophesy, we have a very specific prophetic protocol that we follow when we minister to people. Now, I want to quickly run through this prophetic protocol. And I think when you start to prophesy, and the gifts of the Holy Spirit is activated in your life, it will also help you to follow a similar protocol. Now, I have a protocol for when you receive a word, and I also have a protocol for when you give the word. So on each one of those, I have 8 points in a protocol. So let me quickly run over what to do when you receive a prophetic word. Well, first of all, I believe it's very important that you write the word down. The Lord said to Habakkuk, write the vision down or write the word down. And so that's what you need to do. Date the word, write down the who gave you the word, when it happened. You can write it in a prayer journal and just write down the main things of what God said. Then I like to go and I pray and I ask the Lord for more instructions. Even as I write the word down, the Lord will usually then give me additional things that comes with the word. Well, the second thing that I think should happen is the word needs to be judged. Now, most prophetic words, when they come, you immediately in your spirit know this is a word from the God, from the Lord, and there's a lot of affirmation in your heart about what God said. But sometimes you might have a question about one or two of the things that was said. And so what you want to do is you want to put those words first on the shelf and you want to get the word judged. Now, the scripture says, let two or three prophesy and then let that word be judged. And you can read about it in 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 29. So the process is as follows. You find someone that's spiritual, that's usually a leader, someone that loves you, and let them listen with you to the word. And then they can tell you what they feel God says. Now, usually when people prophesy, it's usually almost all of the word is 100% accurate and people judge it as accurate, and then there might be just one or two details that there's a question mark behind. Now, my advice is if you're not sure, just put it on the shelf and say, Lord, I can't react on that right now. I'm just going to watch and see. Bill Hammond explains it like that. He says it's like a traffic light. You got a green light, that means you must go. Then you got the red light, that means no. And then you got that yellow light, which means you have to wait, be cautious, be careful. And so usually when you get something in a prophetic word that you feel, I'm not sure about it, then it's almost like that yellow light. Just wait a little bit and see what is the timing, what is the method that the Lord wants to use of with that in your life. And then there is sometimes where people make mistakes when they may be immature in their prophetic gifting and they completely miss it. And that's why God put this provision in scripture that we have to get the word judged. Now, if the word was given by a false prophet, like a gypsy or someone that prophesies from a demon or a familiar spirit, then obviously you can scrap that whole word and throw it away. For me, it's also very important that the person that prophesy must identify themselves. So if you receive an anonymous prophetic word, I would also can the word. Okay, so my third protocol would be read and meditate and pray about the word. Okay, so this is what Paul taught Timothy to do, and that's what you also should do. Read the word, have quiet time before the Lord, pray, ask the Lord to give you more revelation, and you'll see the Lord will be faithful to use that word as a door to enter into the realm of the Spirit so He can show you more things. My fourth protocol is allow God's Holy Spirit to bear witness in you. So when you hear the prophetic word, you'll immediately feel the Holy Spirit in you. It will say, yes, this is the word of the Lord. And there will in you usually rise up faith. There will be a confidence. There will be excitement of the Holy Spirit in you that will rise up. And that kind of is a sign and an affirmation and a confirmation to you that this is the word of God. The fifth thing that I want to advise is to get counsel. Especially when the word has some very important decisions in your life, you have to make a decision about your future, then I would say you need counsel. Now, the Lord has given us prophetic words to speak to us. He's given us the scripture to speak to us, but then he has also given other people, like our mother, our father, our pastor, or other minister, to speak into our lives. And so that's why the Lord has given the ministry of the pastor and the prophet and all of that, because the Lord doesn't want you to just hear God's voice. He also wants you to receive prophecy. He also wants to receive information out of the word of God, but he also wants others to counsel us. And I want to advise you, when you receive the word, go to someone that can counsel you. Listen with them to the prophetic word, and then ask the Lord and let that person speak the counsel of the Holy Spirit to you. Okay, my sixth protocol is 3 confirmations before moving or changing your job. Okay, so it's very important. Before you're going to make a big decision in your life, make sure you get 3 confirmations. Now, typically, those should not all be the same. It should not be 3 prophetic words. Maybe one of them can be a prophetic word, one of them can be the Holy Spirit speak inside of you, and then the third one could maybe be your pastor that says, yes, he believes this is a word of God. So that will really help you not to make silly mistakes. Number 7 is war with your prophecy. Now, in 1 Timothy 1 verse 8, Paul talks to Timothy and he says to him, you need to war. It means you have to confess the word. You have to declare the word. You have to take action steps that's in accordance with your word, and be sure to just pray regularly about that word and declare it and take authority. So war with your prophetic word. And then my 8th point is, remember, all prophetic words are conditional, especially personal prophetic words. So there's many examples in scripture when someone received a personal prophetic word, but that word was never fulfilled because the person were disobedient to God, or they were not willing to be obedient. And so therefore, there is a but conditions connected to the word that you received. And so therefore, ask the Lord, Lord, what is the condition that I have to fulfill in order for this word to be fulfilled? The Lord said to the Israelites that you'll go into the promised land, but yet they still had to cross the Jordan. They had to fight all those enemies. They had to march around Jericho. There's a lot of things that the people of Israel had to do. The first generation of the Israelites that died in the desert, they were not willing to do the things that God called them to do. And so therefore, although God gave them this amazing prophetic word, it never was fulfilled for them. And only their children saw it being fulfilled. And so it's the same for us. We have to be obedient to the leading of the Holy Spirit. Now, I've went over my 8 protocols that I use when I receive a prophetic word. Now, I want to go over 8 protocols that I use when I prophesy a prophetic word. And so that is, everyone in our prophetic team follow these same protocols. Okay, so the first protocol is, we set up a meeting and we make sure that we have at this meeting witnesses, and we also have a recorder. So if we do it live on YouTube, on Facebook, it's being recorded, or I'll get my phone out and I'll get the voice recorder and I'll press record and I'll record it, or I'll have a video camera and we record it. It's very important that we record it so there is witnesses, and so that the word, we can go back and listen to it again, we can judge the word, we can verify, we can see who actually gave the word, or you gave the word. So it's very important. Number 1, the prophetic word must always be recorded. Even when John the Revelator went into heaven, the angel said many, many times to John, write everything down that you see. So it's important, it has to be recorded. Number 2, explain the prophetic protocol of receiving the word to the person that's going to receive the word. So just like I went over those 8 points and say, here's a prophetic protocol for receiving the word, just go over the prophetic protocol in short. Make sure they write it down, make sure they evaluate it against the word, it gets judged, and then I got to ask the Lord for specific instructions. Maybe they need to get counsel, they need to get confirmation before they make serious decisions. And so it's important that they understand the prophetic protocol, what to do once I receive the word. Okay, number 3, ask a leader to be present to oversee and to judge. So in our church, I'm the pastor, so usually when the prophetic team is ministering, I make sure that I'm always there so I can provide oversight. And if there's a mistake, or if a word needs to be judged, then I'm available to do that. Now, if you are a prophetic team in your church, make sure that you invite your pastor or a spiritual leader or an elder to be present when you prophesy. And make sure that the leadership in the church are fine with the activity. And so that's why it's good. Set up a time, make sure there's protocols in place, make sure everything is being recorded. And if the prophetic word is very, very specific for someone, sometimes it's better to pre-record it, then give it to the pastor, and then let the pastor give it to the person. Okay, so that's my second protocol. You know, my third protocol is ask the leader to be present. My fourth protocol is record the word and take responsibility by giving the date and the name of who ministered. So when you give a word, you want to make sure, don't open up your mouth and start prophesying unless the recorder is running. Okay, so it's very important. And then the next one, when you start recording, say, hello, my name is Joseph, and this is the date. It's today is the 9th of June, 2022. It's 4 minutes past four in the afternoon, and I'm prophesying to Peter, and then you start to prophesy the word. That way it's very specifically documented, and the administration of that word is in place. I believe that's very, very important. Also, if I put my name on it, then I take responsibility, and it also gives me more credibility as a prophetic minister. Okay, number five for me on the protocol of giving a word is make sure the word that you release is biblical. Okay, so when you speak the word, the Holy Spirit will never speak anything that's contradicting to the Bible. And so as you know your scriptures and you know the doctrine in the Bible, when you prophesy, make sure as you prophesy that you just have a filter there to say, well, I'm not going to speak anything if it might contradict what the Bible says. For instance, if you feel this person needs to divorce their wife, but in the scriptures very clearly, you cannot divorce your wife, then you cannot open up your mouth. You have to say, well, I got this something, but I'm going to rather keep quiet. I'm not going to say it because I'm not sure if this is actually from the Lord. And so then you can pray about it, evaluate it, and then once you made sure whatever you want to say is biblical, then you can release it. So that's very, very important. The Bible is a plumb line. The Bible is a higher authority than our personal prophetic words. Okay, number six. Make sure the word edify, exhort, and comfort. So in 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 3, Paul says that the word that we prophesy must be of edification, exhortation, and comfort. The reason why he says that is because we are in a season of grace, and the Lord is showing so much love and mercy and grace towards people. And so the Lord is not right now going to pinpoint sins in people's lives and try to bring judgment or give a hurtful word, but the word will exhort. Now, there is prophetic situations where the Lord will give a word of correction and help the person to come back into alignment with the Lord. But many times, those words will be given in the context of pastoral counsel instead of in the context of prophecy. And especially when there's a lot of people listening to the word, you definitely don't want to bring a word of judgment because that will expose the sin in that person's life, which is not love. All right, so my point number seven is avoid prophesying about the following things: geographical moves, changing vocations, who you're going to marry, you're going to live or you're going to die, you're going to have a baby, or ordaining the person in a fivefold ministry calling. Okay? Now, the Lord speaks about those things. He actually always speaks about those things. But when you get a word that says this person is going to leave their job, they're going to move to a different city, then that word, you want to actually record it, you want to take it to the pastor, and then you'll ask the pastor to pray about it. If he confirms that as God's word, then you will share that word in a pastoral context with his congregational member. And so that is, especially in a public setting, that's a prophetic word that you want to avoid. But it doesn't mean that God doesn't speak it. It just means that you have to make sure the delivery happens in a different way. And finally, number eight, avoid a word of judgment or questioning the person's calling or giving a word that's hurtful. Okay, and I know there was lots and lots of prophets in the Old Testament that spoke words of judgment. And even Jesus, when he spoke his prophetic word over the Pharisees or over Jerusalem, there was a word of judgment that sometimes came out. And so it is biblical to do that. But I would say for my team, we are avoiding it. And definitely when we're ministering on a YouTube live where lots of people can receive this, we will make sure that our word edify, exhort, and comfort. So now that you've received the prophetic protocol, I want you, if you are sitting here tonight and you would like to receive a prophetic word, write your name in the comments, and I would love to get the team to minister God's word to you. God bless you. It's all right.